Hello people, welcome to this tutorial. I'm going to show you the basics of Ableton Live 9. Please, if you find any mistake or bad pronunciation, correct me in comments straight away. This is Ableton Live 9. There are three different versions of this software, and the slight difference is that in the Suite 1 you have many files and devices to create music with too. This tutorial won't be pretty short. If you are looking for something specific, just check the video description to get the index of what is explained here to save time. Let's have a general overlook about how the software looks like. On top, there is the control bar, where you have options and buttons about tempo, the side dedicated to the player, info about your project, and, on the right, supporting button to link Ableton with keyboards and external instruments. Take a note about this percentage that tells you the overall CPU load when you are going to have complex projects. On the left you have the browser board where you will take all your samples, instruments and effects in general. The central space is divided in two parts. The top one is where you are going to put your sound and music, and at the bottom you will edit such music and add the effects you like. Keep in mind this space on the left. This is useful as a beginner. Here you will have written info about the button where your mouse is, or any bar info. Just a little more help with your first steps. Before we begin, we need to understand how this software manages music. There are two ways to create music, the session view and the arrangement view. You can switch between one and the other through these buttons. In short, the arrangement view is your project in full, that is going to be rendered in the end and will contain your final song. The session view is put aside the other view to let you put music together and make experiments without touching what is done in the arrangement view. Then, once you feel fine with what you have done in the session view, it can be exported inside the arrangement view, ready to be used. Let's start with the session view. Here you have different rows called scenes, and each scene is composed by different columns that will contain the music samples that compose a general part of your music. Each scene is a side and will play all that it is in its same row. Let's see how it works. Use the browser to look for a general audio file to add in WAV or AV format. Just go to the sample section. Just click on it to hear a sample and see its waveform at the bottom. Click and drag it on a clip cell. Let's consider the first row at random. Drag the edges of the columns to change their sides and you will see a vacant space. Let's drag so another file on this space and a new column will be added on its own. This can be a way to add a new column fast. Delete for now the MIDI column, so just right click on it and click on delete. Remember that you can copy, paste, change color and merge completely a column by right clicking on its name. When you will have complex projects in your hands, you may need to manage columns in groups. Just choose group tracks. The column selected will enter inside a new group that will have other columns in, the ones you will move and drag on it. Each column has cells that may be filled by audio files called sample clips. Each sample clip can be played solo through its left arrow. At the bottom for looped clips, you will see some numbers increasing. The right one means the full time duration of the sample clip added. The left one, how many times it has been looped. At the bottom you will have the sends. These state how much of this clip you want to transfer to the output columns A and B in intensity. Output columns are used to put together clips in a percentage that you set through the send knobs. More at the bottom you will find a decibel meter, which shows the volume. Move the black arrow to set the maximum volume, especially to avoid any red color shown. Otherwise, your sound risks saturation or distortion. On the left, you can adjust the panning, which is the intensity of the left channel and the right one in stereo. The number in yellow means that the clip is enabled. Click on it to mute the clip and click once again to make it sound. The small S states to put the clip solo, with all the other tracks being muted. You will have these options for each column. You can play a clip by clicking on its green arrow, and you can stop it by clicking on the square next to the numbers increasing. Clips and output columns are brought all to the master column on the right. Click on the arrow next to one in the master column. All the clips in row number 1 will be played in full. As for the clips, click on the square in the master to stop all. Notice that this will stop just the clips and not the player in your project. The player is on top of the control bar. It is not measured in seconds at all, but in bars and number of beats. You have then the play and the stop buttons and the record button that we are going to see later. The player goes on even after stopping a playing clip, whereas playing any clip or the full row through the master will make the player start. The number of beats per bar is set by the time signature, the fraction you see next to the tempo. Drag the first number to set the number of beats per bar. For more info about the time signature, just have a look in Wikipedia. The number next to the tap word is the tempo, which is the speed of playing, measured in beats per minute. A higher tempo makes the whole project being played faster. You will have some rounded buttons next to the master. These hide or show other options to set up each clip. For instance, the letter R manages the return or output clips, the S the sends, the M the decibel meters, the X manages the crossfade options that help you to put the smooth between the different clips, not to have too much harsh sounds. Click on D for the delay options. There you can set a delay when the column interested must play the clips inside. Add now other audio files, always through the sample section in browser, and put them on a second row scene. If you click the arrows in the master, you will activate a single row at a time. Notice the behavior of the return clips. The associations of the send made with the first row do stay the same for the second row too, and so for the other rows. You can edit each single clip by double-clicking on it. I will dedicate a video about editing clips. For now, let's have a general overlook. Let's see how the arrangement view works. This is your final project, and is composed by different tracks or groups, if you have one. And such tracks are one above another, whose order is not important. The timeline is set under beats and bars, and, on top, you see a small and general description of your project. If you add audio files, they are added in different colors that you can see here, and such lets you find the audio file in the timeline quickly. If you drag with the mouse the black contour, you will move along your project very easily, or you can even zoom in and out by dragging its edges. Add and move each audio file by dragging it inside the track or to move it into another track below. If you want to move more carefully, just hold on Alt while dragging. If you need new tracks, just right-click on the vacant space. You can also set the audio file's length by dragging the edges of the bar that contains their name. Always right-click on such a bar to manage the audio file itself. You can also manage parts of such an audio file or more of them. Drag the mouse to create a blue space and then simply right-click to manage that part of clip or to copy and paste such. You can always undo any mistaken action. Just go to Edit, Undo, or simply press Ctrl and Z from your keyboard. Another quick operation is to make a copy of a selected part. Just drag such part with the mouse while holding Ctrl down. Approach your mouse right below the timeline to start the player from that instant of time. Notice that the tracks on the right are named and are exactly the columns in the session view. However, such columns are empty and new at first, and don't have anything from the session view. To copy from the session view, you need to use the record button. Go back to your session view and play the raw C or the clip that you want to import inside the arrangement view. When you reach the right point, just click on the record button. While the session view plays with the record button on, the bits from that view mode are imported bit by bit in the arrangement view, in the tracks that correspond to the columns in the session view that contain such clips. Click again on the record button to stop recording. In this way you will add the parts of the session view that you think that it fit better. Watch out of the playing in the arrangement view. To play all inside, click on the orange button called Back to Arrangement. All the tracks will be played. This can be seen through the session view too, where, above the sands, you can see when the single track columns are being played. You can use the space key from your keyboard to play and stop fast. Just press it. Now just go back to the session view. When you choose to play one or more sample clips, these will be played according to the session view and not to the arrangement view. In the arrangement view, such clips are shown off and muted, because played according to the session view. If you want to play them according to the set in the arrangement view, just click on the play button on the right, one by one. The Back to Arrangement button just enables all the tracks according to the arrangement view altogether. You can edit each single audio file imported by double-clicking on it, and you can edit each track through the options on the right, but I will explain this in another tutorial. Just be careful not to make overlaps between audio files in the same track, otherwise the parts covered will be fully cut. The last thing we are going to see is how to save files. To save the project, go to File and then to Save Live Set. When you save it, the project is all inside a black folder. Inside, you have different files that are needed to open the project in a second moment. Usually, Ableton projects are .alls files. If you want to render the audio file instead, just go to the Arrangement view and drag the mouse selecting the part you want to render. Then go to File and go to Export Audio Video. A new window will make you edit preferences. You can also select the track to render through the timeline selected. Choose Master if you want to render all in full. Then just click on OK. Your first song is done. Thanks for watching this video. However, this is just an introduction of what you can do in Ableton Live 9. Check the next videos to know how to edit clips and tracks, how to place effects, and how to use MIDI files. See you!